you guys. Welcome back to the Art Playground. I'm going to just give you a minute to filter on in as I go ahead and share this stream into the Art Playground group on Facebook. La 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 la. Okay. Art Playground. There we go. It is done. It is done. That quick. Yay. Okay. Make sure we're on Twitch. I did not check YouTube, but that's okay. I'm sure you guys will let me know if it's not working. So, pardonnez-moi. Due to the contest that I'm running right now on Instagram, I shared the two winners so far. And today I am going to actually work on a Secret Santa gift for someone that loves Queen, cats, and apparently Jack Daniels. But I think I'm going to focus on the Queen and the cat. So we're going to do a fan art Friday today, and I will share on the screen inspiration that I'm looking at on Pinterest to try and get this creative thing that's in my head out onto paper, because I need a little visual reference of Sir Freddie Mercury. But join in the chat, and if you guys have any questions about anything related to me and my art, please go ahead and ask it, and I will be happy to talk with you. So what I have in front of me, because intuitive artist, I just got out some watercolor paper. This is actually Art by Marlene watercolor paper. It is 300 GSM, which I believe converts to 140 pounds. I was going to try and work on a canvas board, but I like painting on things that have a little bit of give and flexibility. So I'm not that comfortable on canvas boards. If it was an actual canvas, I'd be fine. So that's where we're at. I am going to go ahead and flip you down to the three camera angle sets, which I've changed up a wee bit. So here we go, a three, a two, and a one. There's a couple things popping up. Okay. I shared it. Yes, I shared it. Thank you, Nikki. So bizarre that it puts myself on there. Okay. So, these are some of the types of things that I was giving away in the 12 Days of Christmas. And thank you to the two wonderful people that entered the first day and the second day. But so they are getting goodies like these, plus some extra bonus ones. It'll be surprises. I haven't decided what yet. Maybe one of the bigger ones. I'll have to see where they live to see how much shipping costs. But due to lack of interest at this time, I'm not going to continue doing it. Maybe we can do it again in the future and have some fun giveaways. But we tried. So congratulations and thank you for participating, ladies. Number one. Okay. We can move the keyboard off because I don't need that now. But yes, Freddie Mercury and cats. So I'm not surprised that other people have already done versions of it, but Freddie Mercury did love cats, like physical cats, not the musical. He may have liked the musical too, I have no idea. But as I was laying in bed, waking up many times during the night, I was thinking of doing a crossover and doing a cat as Freddie Mercury, which is what I think I'm going to be doing. And this morning when I got up and started searching on Pinterest, I was gathering photos of Freddie Mercury and of his crown and his robes and jackets. And then I thought, let's just see. And so I put in Freddie Mercury as a cat. And yes, there's a few that have done that. So we are just going to play and see what comes out of my pencil and paper and paints. I was thinking of doing two small ones and then picking the best, but maybe I'll just do it this way and keep our fingers crossed that it's going to look good and it's going to be nice enough to give away as a gift. If not, I have a backup gift. I have pulled out... one of the Christmas ornaments I painted a couple years ago. So this is a backup. Kathy, thank you for liking the stream. Oh, Jen, but people that lived in the U.S. were going to win digital items from my Etsy shop. But that's okay. It's okay. We'll do it again some other time. And then I have one of my soldered necklaces. I'd give up chocolate, but I'm not a quitter. And one of my postcards. So that is the plan. That I have a safe backup if this painting does not work out. Yeah, no, that is, I was trying to convey that, but it probably didn't read well. I need to polish up on how to do contests, I think, online, because it is a new realm for me. Yeah, see, you got confused. Yeah, no worries. I figured people probably were, and I thought, you know what? I'm just going to watch how other people do their contests and learn and go from there. So, Freddie Mercury has a cat. I have it on my Pinterest. I'm going to show you what I'm looking at on Pinterest. Hello, Esther! Hello! Okay, I'm going to show you what I have on Pinterest. It's going to cover my face for a moment, and then I'll probably put it off to the side while I do creating so that only I can see it after, just so it doesn't kind of muddle up the stream. But here is what I am looking at. It changed the screen. So yeah, here we go. Pinterest. There we go. Freddie Mercury. See? Look at this. Don't stop meow. Come on. Freddie Mercury. Don't stop meow. So here's Freddy. I'm pretty sure it's showing on the screen. Yes, it is. Okay. So, and then I was debating, do I need to show his teeth? Doing teeth is not a strong point of mine. Oh, yeah. See, Jen, I thought that maybe some people would pay for shipping. So I need to figure all that stuff out and redo it. Maybe we can do a spring one. Yeah. Because I thought some people that did want either the stamps or the book or that, or even the cards, might want to pay, like have the option of paying for the shipping. And that's kind of why I did it, then the Etsy coupon, but then I didn't want people to, I didn't want it to read that I expected you. Here, I'm going to take this off the screen as I keep talking. I didn't want it to look like I expected people to pay money in my shop. I wanted to give them something from the shop. And like I said, I just don't think the contest is reading well. So I'm giving out the prizes to our two winners. And then we'll learn. I will learn. And then I'll run another contest later on. So no worries. Maybe we'll do like a New Year's giveaway and that'll be one of the big items or something. And that'll be open. If someone lives outside of Canada, then they can choose. Maybe I'll do that. He does. He smirks a lot because he was conscious of his teeth. And so lots of times he did just smirk and have his lips closed. But his teeth are so him. But then so is the mustache, right? Sorry, those are girls I was looking at for other inspiration. But yeah. The big crown. He always has a... Almost always in his photo, he sees a little twinkle in his eye. But yeah, look at those cats. They're huge. So last year, if you recall at this time, I did a painting for the other person that I had last year in the gift exchange. Oh yeah, you can't see him again. I'm looking at Freddie. So I did that and sent it off to them. And I actually did a painting of the person and they really liked it. But this person's kind of hard to read and I couldn't find them online. Thank you for the follow, Don't Need a Gun. Make my birdie num num fly. And so this person, I tried searching for them online to see if I could find them, to find a picture of them so I could paint them. But They are either very well hidden on social media or they're not on social media, so I could not find them. So that is why it's Freddie Mercury, possibly as a cat. I'll show that again. Yeah. I like this black and white one that I just changed how it looked where it says save because it shows like his muscles and his arms if I actually do try and do like his chest area. But then I do really like the idea of the jacket, either the yellow jacket or a nice robe. And of course the crown. The yellow iconic jacket. He has his Harlequin type outfit too that I was looking at, but then I have to think about how it curves around his body, so. Okay. Mr. Freddy, let me find one. Which one are we gonna play with here? I couldn't find one of him just standing in the yellow jacket. Because he's a mover, he was a mover and a groover, so one of him just standing with not like with his side profile was very hard to find. Look, someone did him as the lady in gold. Isn't that awesome? A lot of people have done him as artwork. Oh, Freddy. I was in an open air market in Auckland, New Zealand, when it was brought over the airwaves that Freddie had passed. I always remember that. Okay. I am going to look at that one just for his face. This one's smaller. Okay, Mr. Freddy. So, whatever you guys are doing at home, go ahead and just create along with me. I was thinking maybe next Friday. What is next Friday? Next Friday is what, the 11th? Today's the 3rd. I think it's the 11th. 10th. And maybe we should paint some ornaments. I think that would be fun. I think that's what we should do next Friday. Paint ornaments. If you don't celebrate Christmas, you can paint a positivity ornament that you can just hang in your kitchen all the time or something, right? Or whatever holiday you celebrate. Okay. I did bring water in here with me today, so I'm one up on that. Just gonna grab a pencil. I am thinking I'm going to watercolor. Pencil, pencil. I find the purple ones. I want the blue one. The purple and pink Kali erase pencils, when you get the lead wet, the colors do bleed a bit. So that's why lots of times I do stick with the blue. So does the red. The red bleeds a bit too. Which means it like runs into the water. Okay. There we go. There's some goodies. There's some creative goodies. Look, a crown for inspiration. A sharpening. I knew it was there. I knew it was there. Doesn't want to sharpen. There's nothing in it. Maybe that sharpener's just done. It doesn't want to sharpen. Okay. I'm gonna go with it. Do we do him as a cat or do we do Freddy? Should we try sketching Freddy and if I fail ultimately, then we switch to a cat? I'm not great at guys. They are my work in progress area. Where's my, actually, let's see. I'm gonna go grab a picture of that cat he's holding. One of those big chubby cats. Do, 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 do. This one. This one. This one. See, he didn't even have a preference for if it was orange or. Okay. Freddy, 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 Freddy. Okay. You have to get in the zone. You totally have to get in the zone. I need room for a crown. Room for his face, and then possibly like the top of his jacket or the robe, the regal robe. So funny how you get used to working on the iPad, because that's what I do like almost every night now with stamp creations. If I'm doing a cat, I don't have to worry about the neck. Right? Funny how I can see how uneven they are when I look at the monitor compared to when I'm looking at the page. So different perspectives are good. Oh, make him like your girl's, but instead of wild eyelashes, give him a wild mustache. Yeah, it would have been cool too. Like, if I could have found a picture of this girl who's getting the gift. Sorry, I'm like. To turn her into Freddie Mercury. Like, that's what I wanted to do, but I just couldn't find her. Ooh, my line's off a bit. And his mustache. She may hate it. She may be someone that just will get it and go, oh my god, what is this? That's a chance you take, I guess, when you're doing a gift exchange with a stranger. And you don't give very much information. I always try to give a lot of information. Thanks, Julia! How are you? How is everyone? How is your week? I went and I got my flu shot for the very first time last Friday. And it didn't start off well, but it got better. I had an allergic reaction. It's not funny, but knowing I'm okay now, it's funny. My blood pressure went up, up, up. Verna! It's because you're alive. I almost passed out, and then when I went to leave, they made me wait 15 minutes and I was feeling better, so then I went to leave, and when I was walking towards leaving, hello, Purpleina! I felt like my head was bouncing up off my shoulders, like in the air, just floating. So I kept like walking in circles and not leaving just to see how I felt. And then the nurse came out and she was like, are you okay? So I told her. And so then they checked my blood pressure and it was 176 over 107. So they had to give me Benylin, and we had to call my husband. I had to stay there about an hour. But I'm vaccinated. I know. It was a little freaky. Not getting the other side of his mustache. It's so funny. Like, with working on the iPad, I would go, I really like this side of the mustache, but not this one, so I'd erase that. And then you just copy this, flip it, and move it over to the other side. Sometimes I won't let you leave. I know. They were debating. I was hooked up to the blood pressure monitor. Like I said, thankfully I started feeling better. Okay, come on, mustache. I keep looking at Freddy over here. It's almost looking like the Lorax is the mustache for some reason. We'll get paint on there. Is that our car or the neighbor's car? I think it's the new neighbor's car. I'm gonna move that up, 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 up. So I'm not like hiding behind it. It's the neighbor's car. Okay. Freddy, Freddy, Freddy. So his hairline and the crown. Let's go to a different photo. So I'm not going to worry about the ears, because the ears are going to be in the crown, right? So he doesn't have his hairline, he only has like his sides peeking out. It's quite the crown. The crown that I love. Oh my gosh, when we went to see Queen a few years ago and it was Adam Lambert, the crown that Adam Lambert wears, you guys have probably heard me talk about this before, I want that crown. Just let me wear that crown for a day. It's like full on bling. It is amazing. Absolutely amazing. I'm gonna have to start putting down the iPad more because I'm not switching well in between the two. Okay, so we're gonna have some hair here and here, some fur. Do I want his ears sticking out the side? Should I actually pay attention to what other artists did? They didn't put the crown on the cat, did they? Did anyone put the crown on the cat? Nobody put the crown on the cat? Damn. I'm gonna put the crown on the cat. Okay, so. Do I put ears out to the side and then have the crown sitting on top, or do I just cover up the ears? The cat ears. You like the video of how I started my journey? So cool. Do you just mean the one about last year, Verna? Oh, look at that. My chat's over. Let's move the chat up. Moving it to the top of the stack here. Or do you mean the one where I was at the art gallery talking about how I came about my style and everything? The one at the art gallery? Yeah, that was fun. That was so cool to see some of my big art pieces on display. Yeah, that was fun. I liked that. Okay, so we're gonna do hair bits. So it's gonna have like hair bits. It's gonna make it floofy hair. Maybe his cheek has to come up further or something. And then he's got floofy hair. I'm gonna make his crown squat because I made him pretty big. I don't know if I'll do the ears. Look at that. That crown looks like it's plastic. It really does, but if it was, it wouldn't have stood up for how long he used it, I don't think. But it looks like, compared to the crowns you would get now for a show, like I said, like the one that Adam Lambert has, this one just, it looks plastic in the photos. Kind of gold filigree around it. Like I said, I'm not going to worry about getting it all because I can't fit it all in. So this comes up to here. Out. Up to here. Come out. Okay. Artistic license. Do, 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 do. I'm not going to try to make it exact because we just want to get the essence of Freddy. Am I near all the flooding? It's about half an hour or 45 minute drive from here to Abbotsford anyhow. That's where a lot of the flooding is, which a lot of us have learned. I didn't know, my family didn't know. The area where a lot of the flooding is in Abbotsford, it used to be a lake. And in the early 1900s or something, I don't know the exact date, so they drained it and put up a dam and then used it as farming community. Don't live below sea level. If ever you can avoid it, do not live below sea level. Chances are, it's gonna flood. So we live in a higher elevation. We are near a beach. We are near the coast. Like, we can walk down to the beach, but we're at a higher elevation. And we're not on a cliff. I don't like cliffs either. I know all the cattle and all the different farming animals. And I don't know if this other guy was affected, but there was a gentleman, I guess him and his family are that, they started a saffron farm in Abbotsford this summer because they found that saffron can grow here. And it's quite expensive to buy. And so it was like, he's like, this is what I'm doing. This is what I'm farming. So I don't know if he's lost all that or not. But yeah, it's not good. But yes, if ever you are looking for a new home, check the sea level. Check what used to be there, even if it's 100 years ago. Do some research. I think I might add this one. I don't know. Yeah, it's very sad. And like I said, a lot of people, like my generation and that, they probably had no idea it used to be a lake there. Saffron is very expensive. Yeah, so that's why he's like, oh, maybe we can make it less expensive here. We can grow it here. Okay, I'm going to look up his jacket now. Because I think I'm going to try and do the yellow jacket. I love that jacket. I hope this person likes this. Wonder if there's a way. I'm not good at hands. Maybe I can do a paw holding the mic. I don't know. We'll see. Oh my god, if he just had his two teeth. Thank you for asking. But yeah, we're okay. We do have gas restrictions and stuff though, because they're finding it harder to get things into here. So thankfully, I think people have stopped hoarding the food, because that was just silliness. It makes me worry if we ever have, like, a true, you know, like, something really tragic and bad, really bad happens, because the people that panic and go out and hoard cause a lot of the problems. Because otherwise, we'd all be fine, there'd be enough for everyone, but it's the people that panic and go hoard and do everything that make it quite difficult. That's also why we have the gas restrictions too, because people were filling jerry cans and silly stuff. So when you're trying to do something like this, just go for some. You don't have to get all the details in there. Just some of them. Just some of the ones that kind of stand out. It's so funny, when I knew I had to get this present out by December 4th, I was like, oh yeah, I have tons of time. And then all of a sudden it's like, oh, today is December 3rd. Because I actually thought, oh, I can get up and finish designing my stamps that I'm working on. But it was like, oh, hang on. That arm's not going to look right. I think I'm going to put a mic, like, over here. Because I'm thinking they're going to frame around the edge, right? So, if they like it. Hopefully they like it. I remember one year, it was at my husband's work party. I won these ornaments, and they were, back then I thought they were ugly and I didn't like them. Teresa, thank you. And we kept them for a few years and we put them up at Christmas, and then I finally donated them because I didn't really care for the style of them. And now I would love to have those ornaments. I wish I'd kept them because it was like funky art. And I just think they're so cool now, but I don't have them. The 4th. I know. December 4th. Isn't that... Where did the year go, guys? It's crazy. We're coming up on the end of like the second year of hanging out at home. We actually invited some small group of friends over for just a festive little gathering, and I'm talking like small group, and almost everyone can't make it because everybody either is still not comfortable or they've just got into new habits. So we have two people coming, which is great because we haven't seen them in 2 years. So these two people that are coming, we are going to have a fabulous visit with. But everybody's like got their quote unquote new normal kind of life. And we're just not seeing anybody. I'm going to have the jacket just fade off at the edge. I'm going to paint fur underneath. I don't know if I'll use black ink or not. I didn't get his cross down. I'm just gonna make it kind of look the way it's supposed to look. Not worry about the details too much. Maybe that's what it is. It was going down too far. Okay, Freddy's eyes. He has brown eyes. Oh, what a sweetie. Your mustache is a little crooked there, Freddy, even though you're smirking. I don't have him looking off to the side, I think. Freddy. Okay. So he needs a bit over his crown. Hang on. Where's that crown? Crown, 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 crown. That's totally different. No, it's not. It's a different angle. It's a different angle. So these just need some filigree. So we're gonna do it squigglies. Okay. Now, what color? Okay, so we know we want to do his hair like here, dark, same with his eyebrows. Should we do him like a tabby cat? Okay. I am going to Oh. Is this my glaze? Glaze. Come on, work. Okay. White face so eyeliner can show up. But I'm so as a white cat? Oh yeah, because he's gonna have the yellow jacket too, right? This is showing up. So this is a glaze pen I'm using, and it's gonna work like a resist. So the water won't go on these spots I'm drawing. By tilting my page a bit, I can see them better as to where the ink is coming out. I don't know if you guys can see it yet. It showed it for a glimpse in the top frame. There. See it? Right there. Do you have an overhead light when you're working? Yeah, I have a ring light here in front of me, and I have a diffused light over to the side. I think that's all I need to be. You can see it. There's his eyes. And a heart on the nose. Do I keep the teeth? I think I keep the teeth. I think the teeth will look good. Okay. Time for some watercolor. And my pencil line still will show, but I personally like that. I like seeing the underlying work. I like to see how people created things. Something just fell outside. Okay. You'll see it more, like I know it's really faded now, but that's because of the light sketch. But as I paint it in, you'll be able to see more and more. I'm going to. Where should I start? Looking at my other palettes here. Deep breath, I know, right? Because this is where this is where Nikki can mess it all up. That's okay. It's all good. We need to try things, and like I said, if everything fails, I have a backup. Okay, I think I'm going to start with like a skin tone, even though he's a cat, and we're just going to build. So I'm just adding some water first. I can't believe it's already December. It's gonna be like New Year's before we know it. I'm gonna have to refill that. I'm running out of Titan Buff in my palette. So I'm starting in the areas that I know would be darker, and then I'm slowly pulling it into the lighter areas. Looks really weird right now. Michelle, hello. I hope I pronounced that right. My dogs. So you always do wet on dry? No, I change it up. You get different effects. depending on how you do it. If it's a larger area, I tend to get it wet first most of the time. Ah, you're from Pakistan. Welcome. I teach examples how to do that and the differences it makes in my online class, the Down the Rabbit Hole class that's available in Teachable. I go over all the different kind of techniques you can use. We'll have to give him some dark chest hairs. Ah, yeah, you can see I'm doing something. Hang on a sec. I need to turn that off. Okay, they're gone. I just got rid of them. Sorry, I had to get rid of that person that was in chat. Thanks, Jen. You should go for a dive, Verna. You should. Sorry, that guy was a spammer that was in the chat. No can do. Spammers. I've had them on Twitch before. I haven't had them on Facebook, so that was new. I had to find out which page he was watching on. I think he knew his jig was up when he saw I was going to Facebook. Oh! How? Dude. Seriously, dude. I know. So he's obviously gone to a different page now. So I blocked him, and yet he can still comment. If you block someone, they shouldn't be able to comment. Okay, so Sorry, I'm just gonna check. I only see yours now, Verena, on Facebook. His are gone. Maybe it just took a moment to get him blocked. Meh. We don't need that. There's no time for that. Please. Dude, go away. You're still commenting. That's great. Go spam someone else. I am not giving you any more effort. Don't worry, I have a techie husband. I'll get him on there soon. No, it has nothing to do with you being on Verna. It's just Facebook is a public platform. If they were on Twitch, I could easily block them. No worries. That's the problem with, that's the downfall of being online, is you have to put up with other stuff. Oh, that one's red. I missed red ones. Okay. Maybe they're gone now. Gonna do a brighter red for the other ones. Ah, dude, get alive. They like attention, so if you give them none. Or I'm gonna do a base underneath the gold. I just don't want to get up to anywhere that's really wet, because the colors will bleed into each other. 1, 2, 3, 4. This one. I might do some black outlining on it, because then I can add in little filigrees and stuff in the gold work. We'll see. Lots of times you'll see me using smooth Bristol paper made by Canson when I'm doing pieces I'm going to add into my journals. This one right now is the Art by Marlene watercolor pad. It's 300 GSM, which is 140 pounds, and it's cold press, so it has some texture on it. When it comes to journals, my favorite is the Stillman and Burn. Red's bleeding. Oh well. I really like that mixed media paper. But sometimes if you go to your local art supply store, a lot of times behind the counter they'll have samples. And so they'll give you like a little square piece of paper. Like when I went the second to last time, I asked them and they gave me pieces. And so I used it for the tip-ins in my book to test it out, and I have the brand names written on them and that. So like, here's another one. I'm in the sticks. Okay, well, when you do an online order, ask them if there's some samples. I know that when I've ordered, like, I've done some paint supply orders from Jackson Art Supplies, which is actually in the UK, but I could get items cheaper on there than locally, or they weren't available locally, the ones I wanted. And in their shopping thing, online shopping, you can choose samples of paper and you pay like $1 a piece or something like that. But that way you can try a bunch of different types to see what you like. So there's some different ways to get them. You're in the sticks. I can't imagine, like, oh my gosh. Years and years ago, like, when we couldn't do, like, online or something, and you did, like, live in the sticks and just couldn't get any art supplies. Tragic. That'd be hard. Oh, I didn't do his mustache. Shoot. Good plan, Stan. Yeah, ask for samples or go and check out if they have samples that you can pay a little bit for. Because even like watercolor paints, the higher end watercolor paints like Daniel Smith and a bunch of other ones will have these things called dot cards that you can buy. And there's this little dried dot of the watercolor on there. And then you can check it, like play with it a little bit and see if you like that color before you invest in a tube. When I wanted to start getting some Daniel Smith watercolors, my mom bought me the dot card as part of my birthday present. And now this palette is mostly Daniel Smith's after a few years. This person lives locally. I was going to go put it in their mailbox tomorrow, like when it's done, but now they're calling for a 90% chance of snowfall here tomorrow. Which then isn't good, because in the places that it's flooding too, that means all that is freezing. But I don't know, maybe that's better than having it wet. I have no idea. I do not know. Is he starting to look like a Freddy cat? I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's yellow. It's going to get so ugly before better. Yeah. In the summer now there's so many forest fires, and now in the winter months we're getting flooding. Someone is trying to phone my cell phone. Old 18 already. Let me get all the yellow out of the brush. So where are you here then, Verna? Is this the Verna that I know? No, because you have a different last name on Facebook. But do you live locally then? Are you out where the flooding is? You're in Radium. Oh, okay. Yes, I am like, I'm about a 45-minute drive from Vancouver, but I'm down near the border. We can now cross the border, and I wanted to do that, except you have to use this app now, and they want you to put in your passport information and everything, and I'm not too keen on that. I know two Vernas now. Yes, I'm very lucky. The other Verna is also an artist. I don't know if he looks like Freddy the cat yet. Just give him, what, an orange nose? Oh, I should pull up the cat picture again. Sorry. Let's see. Sorry. Come on. Maybe I should exaggerate his mustache. Oh my goodness. It actually pulls down further. Is that what I need to do? Push the mustache? I think so. I have my phone on silent and it just keeps lighting up beside me. I'm gonna have to get lunch soon. Oh my goodness, pardon me. I have to start making him look more like a cat. Oh my goodness. Pardon me, I need a lozenge. I smelled them. Okay, let's play with his mustache a bit. Don't worry, I just have a cough because I checked with the doctor. It's just all the dry air. And in this room, too, I have the heat vent closed. So it gets a little cooler in here. Mustache looks a little more Freddy. Still needs to kind of go, like, on the sides a bit. It's just wet underneath here, so I don't want to pull it down too far yet. But I started giving him the whiskers on there. You see the whiskers? Be careful, some spots are still wet. He's looking cool, thank you. He's starting to come together. You're gonna have to take the dive. Yes, take the dive. Adventure into Wonderland. It's a fun class. I have a lot of water in that crown. It's taking a while to dry. I'm gonna add some gold. Where did I put it? There it is. I'm looking to see which gold best matches the accent lining on his jacket. And then the crown will be a different one. See, if somebody makes you a gift, it does take a lot of effort. Need some gold flecks in his eyes too. Normally you would leave whatever you wanted white, white, and not paint on it, but I did kind of get some color over top of his teeth. So I'm just going to go back in with this white from Jane Davenport. Might as well add some to his eyes. Probably put some on the fluff of his crown as well after. Hi, Joanne. Happy Friday. How are you? My stomach is grumbling, saying it's past lunchtime. But I'm on a roll. Oh, yes, Saturday for you. Happy weekend. I know. He's getting there. He's looking more like a Freddie Mercury cat. He looks awesome. Thank you. He is a gift for someone in a gift exchange. Secret Santa. I'm awesome under pressure. Thank you. I'm like that with lots of things. I'll think about it a lot and get stressed and everything. But then when it comes like down to the wire, it all works out. I overthink things a lot. He needs golden whiskers. Oh, you had a button up there too. Oop, that was a little thick. Oh well. Kathy, thank you. It's all about building. At first, it wasn't looking like him too much. You almost wonder, in case they don't like it, if I should just put a note saying, if this isn't your cup of tea, please share it in this group so that someone else may enjoy him. Hopefully they like it. Those are, you know. Too much color. Trying to get his lip to show, but just not too much of it. So we do want the teeth to kind of stand out a wee bit. Glad you guys can't hear it growling. Oh, I didn't do that. Gotta give him some chest hairs. Having the overhead light sometimes make it so I can't see. So if you see me tilting my head in a funny angle, that's just me trying to see like beyond the glare of the lamp. He almost looks like a nutcracker. More gold. Oh my god, we're 2 hours in. Okay, that's a long video to have on YouTube. I am going to leave you guys here because I need to let this dry, and then I am going to maybe the snow won't be too bad. I'll either have to mail it later today or I'm going to have to drive it to them on Monday and sneak it into their mailbox. I will post the final on Instagram so you will see it there. And if he turns out really well in the end, I may put him up for prints, like printables in my Etsy shop or something. Just because he's turning out cute. I'm pleased so far, so fingers crossed. So I wish you guys a fabulous, fabulous weekend. Go enjoy yourselves. Fill your buckets. Fill your joy. Do some minimum 15-minute kitchen dancing. Crank your favorite tunes and groove however you can. So take good care of yourselves, and I will see you right back here next Friday where we will do Christmas tree ornaments. And if you don't celebrate Christmas, you can do an ornament for something else. So gather up what you have to make an ornament. Thank you, guys. You're so awesome. Okay, take good care of yourselves, and I'll see you soon. Remember to like and share if you had fun here. Okay, bye for now, guys. Bye.